Well, it was actually 22 years ago yesterday that Del Wehome first got in touch with me. She was concerned about a law which had recently been passed called the Plant Variety Rights Act, which said that people could take out what in effect was the equivalent of a patent on cultivars of native trees and so on. And she had a concern that no one should be able to patent a tree, and that all of that had been done without our people's knowledge and so on. And then some time later, a number of other people, like Sana, John Hippolyte, Tamafuata and so on, got together after an ethnobotany hui that was held in Christchurch, and with the help of Oliver Sutherland and Murray Parsons, two scientists, Murray is Kahuna, they then came to see us in our office in Wellington about laying a claim to the tribunal based on the passage of that Plant Variety Rights Act and a number of issues of concern about what was happening to our taonga and what was happening to our mātauranga and so on. And so the first claim, or the first meeting of the original six claimants was held in 1989 in our office. It was revolutionary in a sense because no claim had been laid by a number of different iwi before. They'd all been iwi-specific claims, so that was new. It was also quite revolutionary really because it wasn't about a particular piece of land or a river or something like other claims had been. It was about our intellectual property, about our knowledge, the protection of our knowledge. And at the time that was something quite new, something quite exciting. And so we drafted a claim, and then just shortly after that, through work that I was doing at the United Nations on the drafting of the Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples, I was invited to an international Indigenous knowledge conference in New York. And so Del came with me to that conference. Through the relationships that were established there, we got a number of Indigenous experts who subsequently contributed to the claim and so on. And then it just developed over the subsequent 20 years with considerable delays by the Crown. And one of the disappointments for me is that because of the delays by the Crown, the lack of resourcing they were giving the tribunal, a lot of the things that the original claimants were worried about were actually taken away. The government introduced policies that allowed greater freedom in taking our plants. There was more and more protection removed for our taonga and so on. And so the longer the claim went on, the more the issues that our people were raising were being dismissed by the Crown. And that was one of the great disappointments, I think, for the claimants and certainly for me.
So that international forum that you went into with the, you know, the early stages of the claim, does that international interest remain? And is there international interest in this claim?
Yes, but what happened was in the drafting of the United Nations Declaration of Rights of Indigenous Peoples, one of the issues which was raised by Indigenous peoples around the world was the issues that the claimants were talking about here. So the tangata whenua in, say, Brazil were worried about biomedical companies going into the Amazon forest and taking their rumua, patenting it and so on. So it was an issue that was just beginning to be of concern to Indigenous peoples around the world, and so the claim was timely and it gave other Indigenous peoples a chance to see the Māori people are trying to do something, what can we do? And there's always been tremendous interest in what the claim was trying to achieve, the issues it was trying to raise. And as the claim expanded, other Indigenous peoples said to us, can you consider things like genetic engineering, genetic modification, which all impacted on our mātauranga and so on, so the claim sort of incrementally expanded as well.